It's time for the 2017 Golden Bears basketball on the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR. Tonight's game is NCAA Division II basketball tournament between our Kutztown Golden Bears and the IUP Crimson Hawks. Today's game is brought to you by the KUR and the Golden Bear Network. Now let's take you live to Joe Retton Arena at Fairmont State University for all the Kutztown basketball action right here on KUR.
Live from Joe Retton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University in West Virginia, it's NCAA Tournament Division II action here, and it's the Kutztown Golden Bears taking on the Indiana University of Pennsylvania Crimson Hawks. Josh Liddick here on the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR, the Golden Bear Radio Network, and we have a dandy of a matchup. A 4-5 seed game, 3 games prior to this already today, and what a game, what a weekend it has been to start here. A 6-hour drive yesterday through the blizzards, all the way through Pennsylvania, through Maryland, and to West Virginia, and here we are today, tonight, as we get ready for this matchup between Kutztown and IUP. It's going to be a good one. These two teams know each other well, both in the PSAC conference, and two teams that have played each other once this season, and yeah, it was a close one between these two teams. It was a 77-76 victory for IUP back on December 4th of 2016, the last calendar year in the middle of this season. Kutztown was previously undefeated going into that game. They were 6-1 against IUP, who was number 12 at the time. It was a 77-76 game, so it was a good one, no doubt about it. And it came down to the absolute buzzer. It was a 0.1 second layup from Devin Cottrell, who put it up and in for the Crimson Hawks. And that's where they took the victory away from Kutztown. So while it's a 4-5 matchup, two teams here, IUP coming in 27-3, 21-1 in the PSAC. Kutztown has a 26-3 record, 20-2 in the PSAC. Two losses for Kutztown to Shippensburg, who won their matchup earlier today against Virginia Union. IUP 27-3, and the other loss for Kutztown was to the Crimson Hawks, of course, like I said. So two losses to Shippensburg, one loss to IUP, and that's where Kutztown stands at this point in the season. So Kutztown has, it's going to be a close matchup, no doubt about it. Two high-scoring teams that, you know, they have seen a lot, and they have seen a lot of really thrilling finishes this season. IUP, they're making their 15th all-time appearance in the NCAA tournament, including a run of 8 times in the last 9 seasons under their head coach, Joe Lombardi. Lombardi in his 11th season, 252-88. And it's going to be a good one between him and then coach Bernie Driscoll, 9th in the PSAC in total wins, a 286-196 record in his 17th season at the helm. And Kutztown, you know, they have 5 great starters. We've seen them all season long. We know what they're capable of. We have Ethan Ridgeway, number 3, the point guard. He's been unbelievable this season. The all-time Kutztown assist leader, and it was named to PSAC East first team, along with Josh Johnson, who, of course, the senior 6'8". Forward from Norristown. He moved into 3rd in history in points with a 1,690 career points for the Golden Bears. One heck of a player. We've seen so much from him all 4 years of his career, and he also knows how to manage this tournament. He was here last year. Kutztown, of course, getting to the Sweet 16, losing to West Liberty, who West Liberty, by the way, lost earlier on today by one point in controversial fashion to Wheeling Jesuit. So, you know, Kutztown they know what they can expect. They know that Josh Johnson can step up to the court and play really good basketball game in and game out, averaging 15.3 points a game, 7.3 rebounds a game, and he shoots 63% from the field. Struggled a little bit last week against Shippensburg in the PSAC championship game, but you can expect him to rebound, no pun intended on that one, and really showcase his abilities as we get into the game today. A lot is on the line. It's the NCAA tournament. There's so much at stake. There's so much here to look at and so much to gawk at for this Kutztown team. They've accomplished so much this season, and to see it all dissipate after last week losing in the championship game, denied their first PSAC title win in school history. We can anticipate a whole lot this season, and in this game, they don't want their season to end. IUP does not want their season to end. There's going to be one team that will advance to the second round of the NCAA Division II Atlantic Regional tomorrow to face Fairmont State, the number one seeded team in this region. And then there's one team that will kiss their season goodbye. So it's Kutztown taking on IUP, a battle between the 4 and the 5. We see it so many times in Division I, how closely contested those two seeds can be. And we have a great matchup on hand. So we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back with more coverage here from the Joe Retton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University in West Virginia. It's Kutztown IUP coming right at you here. It's NCAA Division II Tournament Basketball on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Be sure to tune in to KUR for your weekly sports talk. Catch Under the Lights with Josh and Paul every Monday night from 6 to 8. Then listen to First and 10 with George Duca every Wednesday afternoon from 3 to 4. Follow that up later Wednesday night with Fifth Avenue Sports with Tom and Connor from 8 to 10 p.m. Stream the shows live at www.kutztown.edu/KUR. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University.
Let's say you're a dad and you want to take your son and daughter on the perfect camping trip. So you pack up the car with all your gear.
We're all loaded up!
And you get the right direction.
Arriving at destination.
And you set up camp right next to a creek.
I caught a fish!
And it all goes perfectly.
Best trip ever, Dad!
And you're the perfect dad. But even if it doesn't go that way and your gear ends up on the highway, and you get completely lost.
Where are you going?
Ugh. And your campground is near a beehive. It can still be the perfect camping trip because kids don't always see things the way you see them.
Best trip ever, Dad!
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of siblings in foster care who'll take you just as you are. For more information on how you can adopt, go to AdoptUsKids.org. A public service announcement from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt Us Kids, and the Ad Council.
Every year, thousands of teens age out of foster care and face life on their own without the love and support of a family. For over 25 years, the Orphan Foundation of America has provided a safety net of support for these vulnerable young people. With OFA's help, these youth graduate from college and trade school, progress to exciting professional careers, and make the leap from foster care to success. Find out how you can support America's foster youth. Log on to orphan.org. That's orphan.org.
Back here at Joe Retton Arena. Back here at Joe Retton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University in Fairmont, West Virginia, on the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR Kutztown. Josh Liddick here bringing you all the action. Kutztown Golden Bears taking on the IUP Crimson Hawks, two teams who found themselves in the top 10 of this year's NCAA and ABC coaches poll, and really, really staying steady all season long up there in the top of the rankings. IUP, of course, right now sitting pretty high up there and doing a really good job at it as well. Kutztown 10, IUP 8 now. So, I mean, there's so much at stake, so much here. You know, IUP, they lost to Shippensburg just a couple of days ago in that semifinal game and went to overtime. Kutztown, of course, they beat Gannon on Saturday, headed over to the PSAC title game at IUP. But the Crimson Hawks were not their opponent in that championship game. Instead, they found the Shippensburg Raiders for the third time this season, and it was a big win for Kutztown. No doubt about it, or a big loss for Kutztown, big win for Shippensburg. IUP has done so well, I mean, this season, looking at them and looking at this team. A couple players to look out for IUP. One is got to be the PSAC West Athlete of the Year, Jacobo Diaz. They call him Kobo, and he has been unbelievable this season. 14.4 points a game, almost 10 rebounds a game, so pretty much averaging a double-double. He is second in the PSAC in double-doubles this season. 13 double-doubles, unbelievable stat there for Jacobo Diaz. Is going to be someone that they're going to need to box out a lot. You know, Diaz is a pretty tall player. Looking at what he is, he's 6'9". So when you have a 6'9 defender out there, he's going to be matched up with Dan Cuevas, no doubt about it. Cuevas is a tough guy. He's a little heavier. He's a 220. Diaz 205, and he's 2 inches shorter than Diaz. But the guy, we know what Cuevas can do. We saw his toughness this season compared to it's a much improved Dan Cuevas than we saw last season. So, you know, it's going to be interesting to see how Cuevas matches up with Diaz. You know, Cuevas a sophomore, Diaz also a sophomore, but he was the West Player of the Year, which is pretty incredible to look at that. Devin Cottrell, talked about him a little bit there. He had 18 points and the game-winning layup against Kutztown in that big game where they laid it up with 0.1 seconds left in the game. It was unbelievable. It's unbelievable to see, you know, how close that game was, how closely contested it was, no doubt about it. Kutztown, Ryan Connolly, holds the all-time record in three-point makes, 215. You know, he's been unbelievable. He has a school record in three-point percentage in a game, 6-6 last year. So the guy can shoot threes. I think it's important for Kutztown in this game to, you know, play the game that they always play. You know, box out, get chances to capitalize on IUP's mistakes, and get the ball rolling early on in the game. We see so many times messing up really, really early on, and, you know, they get opportunities to score, and then they turn the ball over themselves, which allows the other team to score and to get ahead. I think this game is important for Kutztown to really solidify themselves in the offensive part of the game, get on a little run, get going early, and figure out ways to stop this IUP team little by little and eventually try to pull away in this game. Kutztown, they struggled last week against Shippensburg. They only scored 63 points, which was tough. Their lowest scoring game of the season. Today is going to be can't be the day to do that. You can't score 63 points in the NCAA tournament. This is a huge level. Kutztown has been here before. These guys, looking at their starters, I mean, Johnson, Connolly, and Lee, they were starters last year in the NCAA tournament where they got to the Sweet 16 and fell to West Liberty, defeating Mercyhurst and Westchester along the way. Ethan Ridgeway is the only difference, really, and Dan Cuevas, of course. You don't have an Anthony Selby anymore. Ethan Ridgeway is a guy that you're going to put in there. Austin Beidelman usually was the starter. This year, Coach Brody Driscoll really solidified himself and put Ethan Ridgeway in that starting lineup. And safe to say, Ridgeway has thrived ever since. And unbelievable. So it's Kutztown IUP. We got a lot of basketball action here from Joe Breton Arena, Fairmont State University. It's the late game of the night, a big game, of course, and Kutztown looking to keep their season alive and advance to the second round tomorrow night at 7:30 here. Hopefully we'll bring in the action, but let's get a win for Kutztown first. So it'll be Kutztown IUP. We're going to take a quick break here as we pause for the national anthem. We'll be right back after this. You're listening to NCAA Division II Tournament Basketball here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Choose a Kutztown master's degree offering 26 degrees in the arts, sciences, and education. KU graduate programs prepare you to enter the workforce, advance your career, or move into a new field. With international faculty, affordable costs, flexible schedules, and internship opportunities, don't miss out. Apply online or stop by the graduate admissions office conveniently located in Boxwood House on Kutztown campus.
I don't recycle. I mean, we can just find another planet for your kids to live on, you know?
Noted non-recycler Tommy Crenshaw talks about the future.
Oh, I can totally see finding another planet that can support life when ours fills up with trash.
As an alternative to recycling?
Yeah, an alternative. So we, like, don't have to do it. Recycling. There are lots of planets. Finding one is just a matter of time.
Many people say that recycling is pretty simple and convenient. A matter of keeping select items out of the trash. A lot simpler than finding a new planet, Tommy.
Come on, there's a bunch of planets out there.
Would you recycle on this new planet, Tommy? Or just use it up and throw it away, too?
I really don't have a clue.
Log on to yougottabekidding.org and learn about all the ways you can recycle. Unless you're into lame excuses like Tommy's.
Hey, recycling's just not my thing. Starting over on a new planet? Now that's exciting.
Don't be that guy. Unless you want people looking at you funny. Log on to yougottabekidding.org.
Follow KUR, an award-winning radio station, on Twitter to receive exciting daily content delivered straight to your newsfeed. You'll discover diverse music, breaking news, and engaging student DJ content. Visit twitter.com/KURadio to tweet along. Remember to use hashtag KURadio on social media. We are the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR.
I had a sore in my mouth that just wouldn't go away. And after a couple of weeks, I went to my doctor.
A sore, lump, or thick patch in your mouth or throat could be a symptom of oral cancer.
My doctor told me I was smart to come in. He said that oral cancer is more common in African-American men than in any other group in the U.S. It turns out I did have oral cancer, but it was caught early and my treatment was successful. I'm glad I got it checked. That probably saved my life.
If you're an African-American man, you need to know about oral cancer. Visit a doctor or dentist if you see changes in your mouth that don't go away after 2 weeks. It's important to get an oral cancer exam because if you do have cancer, the earlier it's caught, the better. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, National Institutes of Health.
Back here at Joe Renton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University, Kutztown IUP basketball here on the Golden Bear Radio Network. Josh Littick here on the call, and it's going to be a good one, no doubt about it. Starting lineups first for Kutztown: Ethan Ridgeway, Josh Johnson, Ryan Connolly, Anthony Lee, Dan Cuevas. And for IUP, it'll be, let me get this up here, it'll be Anthony Glover, Iron Hutton, Dante Lombardi, Devin Cottrell, and Jacobo Diaz rounding out the starting five for IUP. Kutztown dressed in their away maroon uniforms, trimmed in gold and white. IUP wearing their home whites, trimmed in silver and red. As we are ready to go, and we're underway here as the tip-off goes out of bounds, and Kutztown will take the ball from the baseline and bring it out. As the ref stopping for a little bit, talking to head coach Bernie Driscoll. He's trying to figure out, we're going to start here as we are underway. Johnson inbound pass to Ridgeway. Underway here, Joe Redden Arena. first round of the NCAA Division II tournament. Connolly on the right wing, loses possession of the ball, out of bounds, IUP will take over. So right away, good defense from IUP as forces the ball out of bounds here. Diaz to Glover, and now on the left side, back over to Cottrell. Cottrell guarded by the big body Cuevas. Cottrell puts the shot up, and good from the middle of the court there. 2-0 early, IUP. Johnson's pass stolen away from Diaz. Diaz brings it up for the Crimson Hawks, and back up to Glover. Glover to Lombardi, and back over to Hutton. Tried again, guarded by Cuevas underneath, puts it up, and it is fouled on the play. So it was Devin Cottrell, put it up, no good, and he will go to the line to shoot two. First foul called on Dan Cuevas. Dan Cuevas, we've seen over and over again get into foul trouble and force himself out of the game early. You're going to need him to play the post well and be a defensive presence down there for the Golden Bears. As Cottrell puts the first one up for the Crimson Hawks, it's 3-0 IUP early on here with 18:57 to play in the first half. Second shot is good for Devin Cottrell. So it's a 4-0 lead for IUP. And here comes Ethan Ridgeway, TSAC East first team. Anthony Lee. Lee back over, down underneath, and good. Anthony Lee found the backboard and in, and it's 4-2 IUP. Lombardi. A little dribble drive back over, underneath. Cottrell puts it up and in. So Devin Cottrell, 2 points there. And it is 6-2. And a foul called on the play on the other side. This will be a foul called against Lombardi. To Connolly at the corner. Back up top to Cuevas. To Ridgeway. Top of the key. Ridgeway steps up, takes the shot. That shot is no good. Rebound by Diaz. And now Lombardi brings it up for the Hawks. Lombardi guarded by Johnson. And back up top to Diaz. To Lombardi, top of the key, guarded by Ridgeway. 13 seconds to shoot. 10 seconds to shoot underneath Lombardi. And good. Lays it in with the right hand. And good, 8-2 IUP, the long pass to Cuevas. Cuevas back out to Johnson. Quickly, Johnson puts it up and is fouled on the play. It's a charge called against Josh Johnson. So the ball will go the other way. It'll be IUP ball. Hutton, the inbound pass to Lombardi. IUP cruising with a 6-point lead with 7:29 to play in the first half. Lombardi back over to Cottrell. Sized up a three from Glover. Back top the key over to Hutton. And now to Lombardi. Slow the pace down a little bit. Lombardi finds Diaz from the top of the key. Back over there to Lombardi. Double team. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Lombardi puts it up and good. A little floater from Lombardi. And that will reset it. 17 to play. 10-2 the score. IUP up. Lee underneath the Cuevas, and Cuevas puts it in. Assist for Anthony Lee, and it's 10-4. So Cuevas gets his first basket of the ballgame. Top of the key to Diaz, and then to Cottrell. A shot, good. Drills it in for Glover. Anthony Glover Jr., averaging about 14 a game for the Crimson Hawks. this season. And it is 13-4. Conley, Ridgeway sized up a three. Wisely drives it himself and no good. Cuevas went up for the putback. That's no good. Conley comes away with it. Cuevas puts it up for two. Dan Cuevas. A great play from Conley to capitalize on the rebound. Gets it over to Cuevas and puts it in for the Golden Bears. It's a 7-point game with 15:48 to play in the first half. Cobo Diaz almost loses possession now on the left side. Stolen away, but it's a foul call. Foul called before Lee stole the ball away. It's going to be a foul called against Dan Cuevas, his second foul of the game. Timeout on the floor. 15:40 to play in the first half. IUP 13, Kutztown 6. You're listening to NCAA Division II Tournament Basketball here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Not loud enough. Need something stronger than coffee? Tune in for Scrap Metal with Wiz. Metal, hard rock, Wiz has it all. Stream it live at www.kutztown.edu/KUR. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University.
Back here at Joe Renton Arena, Fairmont State University. First round action here. IUP taking on Kutztown. Your Golden Bears 13-6 early on for the Crimson Hawks with 15:40 to play in the first half. And so far, so good for IUP. They played the game well. They're perfect shooting the ball today so far. Cottrell 2 for 2, 6 points. Lombardi 4 points, 2 for 2. And Glover with a 3-point field goal for the Crimson Hawks. For Kutztown, 4 points for Cuevas. He's 2 for 2. And Anthony Lee with 2 points for his credit and an assist. Josh Johnson, no points, 2 turnovers. And Cuevas saddled with the 2 fouls. As he is out of the game, Max Wagner in the game for the Golden Bears. Ridgeway on the run. Ridgeway will drive, puts it up, no good. Johnson, though, with the rebound. The offensive rebound ain't good. And it's 13-8 the score. Top of the key, and now back over. Diaz guarded by Wagner underneath. Diaz loses possession of the ball. Ridgeway comes up, or Lee comes up with it. Now he's on the run, but he faces 4 IUP Hawks. Ridgeway, and the ball is blocked away out of bounds. It'll still be Kutztown ball. Miller checks into the game for the Indiana IUP. Connolly, Ridgeway. Ridgeway the 3, no good. Wagner with the rebound and good. Max Wagner, the freshman, with the rebound and good. And just like that is a 3-point game. The score. Top of the key. Back over Miller for 3. That's no good, but the putback and in. Cobo Diaz puts up the 2. And the putback in. It's a 5-point game. 15-10. Ridgeway top of the key. He's going to drive to the hole. And he finds Lee open for 3. That's no good. And the rebound made there for number 11, Blake Danielak. Danielak for 3. That's no good. Out of bounds. Kutztown ball. It'll be Kutztown ball trailing by 5 points. Johnson will inbound it in to Ridgeway with 13:46 to play in the first half. trying to advance to the second round, taking on number one seeded Fairmont State tomorrow. Ethan Ridgeway. A little dribble drive back around, a little crossover underneath, and a foul called on the play against the Golden Bears. So another turnover foul for Kutztown. Travel. Glover. Up, and a foul call on the play. So the foul is called on Josh Johnson at his second foul of the game. So two early fouls for Johnson, two early fouls for Cuevas. Not the start you want to have if you're the Golden Bears. Johnson saddled with two fouls. He will likely see the bench for the rest of the half. Seen that last week against Gannon. He had two early fouls early on and saw the bench for the rest of it. Free throw is made for Indiana. And it is a 16-10 game with 13:05 to play. Ridgeway, the shot, that's no good. And the rebound made there for Spain. Out of bounds, still IUP ball. Kutztown trails by six. Lombardi will pass it in for Danielak. And he's guarded there by Connolly. Lombardi on top of the key, guarded by a big man, Max Wagner. Wagner sizes up a little bit. Wide open three. That's good for Danielak. And it's 19-10 the score. Connolly to Ridgeway. Trailing by 9 points. Trying to get their game going. We haven't seen their game yet. Lee, that's good. Little by little, get the twos up there and chip away at this deficit. And then you use your momentum to your advantage. The three ball, that's good. IUP is lighting it up from three early on in this one. Spain with the three ball there. And it's 22-12 IUP with 11:53 to play in the first half. Max Wagner to Lee. Lee underneath to Connolly. Connolly's shot is no good. Wagner went up for it. That's no good, but he is fouled on the play. So Max Wagner fouled there, but he'll go to the line to shoot two. And there will be a timeout called on the floor. Media timeout, 11:44 to play in the first half, IUP 22, Kutztown 12. You're listening to NCAA Division II Tournament Basketball here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Tune in to Notice Latinas Sundays from 1 to 2 here on the Radio Voice, KUR, for the best in Latino news and commentary and music as well. It's Notice Latinas Sundays from 1 to 2 right here on KUR, the Radio Voice of Kutztown University.
Hi, this is Tony Morris. Join me each Sunday here on 1670 AM KUR for Classical Guitar Alive. Each week we explore a wide variety of music with guitar, and you'll also hear interviews with many of the world's foremost performers and composers. That's Classical Guitar Alive right here on 88.3 FM and 1670 AM KUR.
Sundays at 11 AM.
Back here at Joe Renton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University on the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR Kutztown. I'm Josh Liddick, and we have a great basketball game here. Kutztown, though, trailing by 10 with 11:44 to play, and really, it's all been about IUP and the way that they've been shooting the ball. 72.7% from the field, and they have made 3 of 5 from 3, shooting 60% from from three-point land in this one. Really has been hard to do. You know, the Kutztown team, they're 0-for-3 from three-point land haven't been able to get anything going. They're 0-3. The threes is where it comes and goes here. As Wagner at the line to shoot free throws, and the second one is good. It's 22-14. He makes both. It's going to be, we talk about it so much. You're on KURN at KUTV with Tyler Trumbauer, and it's, turnovers. Turnovers, free throws, and, maybe get those three balls going, but we see what Kutztown has done this season from beyond the arc, and it's been very, very respectable. So a turnover from IUP puts the ball back in the hands of Ridgeway. Ridgeway to Lee. And now Wagner shot, that's no good, and the rebound by Cottrell. Lombardi will bring it up for the Crimson Hawks. An 8-point lead for IUP, and Kobo Diaz walks on the play. So it'll be an inbound pass from the sideline right by me on the left side. Ridgeway. Little mismatch there on Kobo Diaz, now on Cottrell. Ridgeway was going to drive. He finds Martin Dietrich. And Dietrich puts it in for two. A 6-point game, 22-16. IUP. Lombardi to Spain. Underneath to Cottrell. Top of the key back over to Diaz. And now back to Malik Miller. Miller drives back up top of the key now again. Underneath, Cottrell, 7 seconds to shoot. Tries to steal away. He does. Max Wagner comes away with the ball. Ridgeway on the run. Ridgeway dishes it back over to Lee, and he has stepped out of bounds. Lee's foot was on the line. It'll be a turnover for Kutztown and a 6-point deficit. Now IUP will have a chance to increase their lead with 10:20 to play in the first half. Lombardi. Back over. And now Lombardi on the left side of the wing. Top of the key to Diaz. Good ball movement by this Crimson Hawk team. Stolen away by Beidelman. Austin Beidelman to Ridgeway. Two best friends there. Spins around, and a foul called on the play. It'll be against Malik Miller. And that will be his first foul of the game. The Kutztown will inbound it in from the baseline. Anthony Lee comes out for the brief moment. Howard Sellers checks in for Kutztown. Howard Sellers from Coatesville, Pennsylvania. Coatesville High School, or came transferred from St. Peter's. And the rebound by Kobo Diaz. The Kutztown gets nothing out of the possession. Once again, top of key to Diaz. And back over to Glover. Glover to Miller. Miller has it. Back to Diaz again. And underneath to Cottrell. Top of the key. Top of key to Miller. Right side. Good ball movement once again. Lombardi, 4-3. Unbelievable. IUP completely draining the three ball in this game. And one of the main reasons why they're up 9 with 9:20 to play in the first half. Ridgeway to Dietrich. Haven't got the three-point play going. Wagner from the corner. That's his sweet spot. That's no good. Beidelman tries to save it. And in the hands of Howard Sellers, and reset the shot clock at 27 now. Back to Beidelman. He's going to take a three. That's good! Austin Beidelman joins the three party. And it's 25-19 IUP. A little life for this Golden Bear basketball team. Kobo Diaz, top of the key, down to Lombardo. Lombardo shoots it. That's good. He drains that ball for Lombardo. 4-for-4 from the field for 9 points. Weidelman, Ridgeway, right side of the wing. Wagner, he's going to drive for two. Off the basket, off the backboard, and good. And it's 27-21. Lombardi controlling the point for IUP. And back over to Glover. Glover's shot, that's good. Another three-point play for IUP. It is raining threes here at Joe Retton Arena, and it's 30-21. Ridgeway steps up, that's good. Good jumper from Ethan Ridgeway. And it is 30-23. 7-point game once again. Foul call on the play. Jimmy against Max Wagner, his first foul of the game. Timeout on the floor. 7:31 to play in the first half. IUP leads 30-23. You're listening to NCAA Division II tournament action here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Listen to KUR every Thursday evening from 4 to 6 Eastern Time for Romp Around Kutztown with Chris Luttrell, the time-traveling troubadour. Tune in for swing, jazz, blues, and trips to the future. Stream it live at www.kutztown.edu/KUR. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University.
Back here at Joe Retton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University in West Virginia. It's the Kutztown Golden Bears and the IUP Crimson Hawks. It's a 7-point lead for IUP with 7:31 to play in the first half of this one. One team advances to the second round of the NCAA tournament, and one team will go home and have their season come to an end. But, you know, whoever does go home, they have a really good schedule and a really good season to look at it. They're really unbelievable seasons for both of these teams. Kutztown, number 10 in the nation right now. They were number 5 last week, 26-3, of course, in IUP. Number 8 in the nation. They were number 2 last week, 27-3. But there's a lot of basketball to be played. Kutztown needs to figure out how to stop this IUP 3-point contest, it seems, from down beyond the arc. And Danielik puts it up for IUP and in. 32-23. Ridgeway double covered. Finds Conley. Back top of the key to Ridgeway. Ridgeway drives. Nothing doing. And blocked away in the hands of Kobo Diaz. Lombardi brings it up. Back to Kobo Diaz. He's going to take a three from the top of the key. That's no good. Rebound by Connolly. Kutztown on the run here. Ridgeway, left side over to Beidelman. Back to Connolly. And he is fouled on the play by Hutton. So Aaron Hutton, his first foul of the game. And now Connolly from the right sideline inbounds it in to Ridgeway. Ridgeway will slow the pace a little bit here with 6:47 to play in the first half. Sellers spins around, double covered, back to Connolly. Connolly underneath the Beidelman. Beidelman up, and that's no good. The rim has not been kind to the Kutztown team on this side of the court. And now on the run again. Lombardi wide open for three. That is good. Another three-pointer for Lombardi. And now he's 2 for 2. And now IUP is up 35-23. Ridgeway. The Sellers. Tiptoes along the baseline. This defense that IUP is throwing at Kutztown is not letting them do their usual tricks. Beidelman's shot. That's no good with the shot clock going down. Rebound by Diaz. Now IUP with the ball once again. Slows down the pace here for Glover. Lombardi guarded by Dietrich. The three from the corner misses everything for Danielik. And now Ridgeway with the ball for the Golden Bears. Top of the key. Ridgeway over to Beidelman. Beidelman double covered back to Dietrich. And now underneath to Connolly. Connolly finds Sellers. And that is good. A great, great assist from Ryan Connolly. Gets it over to Sellers and in. So a 35-25 game. And back to 10 points with under 5 to play. That shot's no good. Diaz went up for it. So a foul called against Kobo Diaz, his second foul of the game. And now Kutztown will take over. So Ridgeway will bring it up for Kutztown. Ridgeway. Underneath to Connolly, and he is fouled on the play. So Kutztown in the bonus. They'll shoot a 1-1 here. Connolly to the line. Get his first free throws of the game, and he misses it. Misses his chance to get one and then possibly two. And now IUP with the rebound. And it'll be Glover. Back over, Glover underneath, puts it up and good, and one. Anthony Glover Jr. puts the two up. And good, and it's fouled on the play. He'll go to the line to shoot an extra one. IUP's up 37-25 with 4:30 to play in the first half. Josh Johnson gets ready to check in for Kutztown with the two fouls to end out the first half here as they get the second one to go in. Howard Sellers comes out of the game. Johnson checks in to the game for Kutztown. Connolly, the inbound pass to Ridgeway. Ridgeway. There'll be a foul called on the play. There'll be a foul called against Spain. And that's his first foul of the game. Ridgeway will go to the line to shoot a 1-1. And he misses it. Free throws have been hard to come by for Kutztown in the last three games. Stolen away. Good hands by Ridgeway. Ridgeway to Johnson. Johnson tips it away to Beidelman. Almost stolen away. Beidelman tries to get it. Back over to Lee on the left side. Lee underneath to Johnson. He's fouled on the play. So a little more life put back into the game for Kutztown. And this time Johnson will go to the line and shoot two shots. Josh Johnson will have his first opportunity to go to the free throw line in this game. Last week, the rim was not kind to Josh Johnson as he misses the first one. Johnson was 1 of 6 from the free throw line last week against Shippensburg in that PSAC championship loss to Shippensburg. And now he's 0-for-1 in this game. And he's 0-for-2. He misses both. Johnson is usually a really, really stellar free throw shooter. And he misses both of those right there. Johnson usually shoots around 69% from the free throw line. And 0-for-2 as the Golden Bears trail by 13 points with 4 minutes to play. A jump ball will be in possession of IUP. So it's 38-25, 21 seconds on the shot clock, 4:01 to play in the first half, and a big 13-point lead for the Crimson Hawks. And this battle between PSAC foes in the NCAA tournament stolen away by Wagner. Wagner, one man to beat underneath, blocking foul, and gets the two and one. So Wagner, great steal, follows through at the layup, gets the foul, and we'll go to line to go for an extra one. So a timeout on the floor, 3:57 to play in the first half. It's IUP 38, Kutztown 27. You're listening to NCAA Division II tournament on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Tune in every Monday evening from 4 to 6 Eastern Time for The Show with Ben Show. Listen to an eclectic selection of hits and music throughout history. It's a musical roulette of fun and good times. Hear it here at www.kutztown.edu/KUR. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University.
Back here at Joe Ritten Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University, it's IUP adds to a commanding 38-27 lead over Kutztown. Josh Liddick here on the call on the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR. B.D. Blake back at the KUR studios. And McFarland Student Union at Kutztown University doing the board hopping. And really doing an excellent job here as we have brought you Kutztown basketball many times this season, and now bringing it to you on the biggest stage of it all, the NCAA tournament. Wagner at the line, and he gets the and one. So brings it back to 10 points. IEP just trying to get the ball in. Double teamed, almost loses possession of the ball now as Kutztown playing that press defense that we all know and love. Almost stolen away by Johnson. Back out to Lombardi. 18 to shoot on the shot clock. Lombardi is going to drive back over underneath to Cottrell. Cottrell puts it up, and he has fouled on the play. And I think that will be against Ryan. It will be against Dan Cuevas. Oh, or Max Wagner. It's Max Wagner. So Max Wagner, his second foul of the game. Cottrell to the line, and he makes the first. So 39-28. Cottrell at the line to shoot two. He has 7 points on the night so far, and he gets the second one. So Cottrell gets his 8th point of the game. He's a perfect 4 of 4 from the free throw line. And it's 40-28, IUP. Ridgeway to Lee. To Ridgeway again. Ridgeway to Wagner. Wagner sized up a 3 and said he's going to take it himself underneath. That's no good. And Josh Johnson. Little boom goes to the dynamite there. And gets the 2 and good. Lombardi, top of the key, and to the left side, underneath to Cottrell. Cottrell guarded by Wagner. Wagner underneath, guarding him. Cottrell puts it up, sizes it up, and gets the J shot in, and good. Devin Cottrell, 9 points. It's 42-30, a 12-point game with 2:50 to play here in the first half. Anthony Lee, that shot's no good. Conley picks up the rebound and said he puts it up himself. Nothing called. And the putback offensive rebound for Josh Johnson. And now this is the game that Josh Johnson knows how to play and plays so well. Back to 10 points, 42-32, with under 2:30 to play in the first half. Top of the key to Lombardi. Lombardi, he's going to take the three. That shot is no good. Rebound by Conley. And now Golden Bears on the run a little bit here. And the pass from Ridgeway turned it over. IUP on the run. That's no good. Rebound by Anthony Lee. There'll be a foul against Lombardi, his second. So that will send Anthony Lee to the line to shoot two as the Golden Bears are in the double bonus. So they have a chance to bring this deficit back down to single digits. Lee, first free throw is good. Wagner, 3 for 3 from the free throw line. And then Lee finally becomes the other Golden Bear to get two there as Ridgeway, Johnson, and Connolly all missed their free throws for Kutztown. The 3 points there. Almost gets the steal. Nothing doing. Lombardi open there for three. He's going to pass it up to the left wing. That three is good from Danilak. He has 9 points. It's 45-34. Ridgeway drives up. That's good. Ethan Ridgeway, he gets two to fall for Kutztown. 9 point game. Stolen away by Wagner. Good hands by Max Wagner. And the foul against Danilak. So right now in this portion of the game with 1:21 to play, Kutztown taking advantage of that double bonus and getting fouls, drawing fouls, getting to the line. And this is going to be where they thrive. They're going to need to figure out ways to shoot a high percentage from the free throw line and get those 3 points. Wagner already 3 for 3 on the night. Wagner's fourth free throw of the night is good. So 45-37. With 81 seconds to play in the first half. And the second one is no good from Wagner. Long pass over. Tries to draw a turnover. Top of the key now to Lombardi. Around half court. Top of the key back over to Danilak. His three. That's no good. And the rebound by Anthony Lee. Lee on the run to Johnson. Johnson, he's going to drive. Puts it up for two. Nothing doing. Falls to the ground. And nothing called. Now IUP's on the run. They're going to run up for the layup. That's no good. Rebound by Wagner. And now Ridgeway on the run for Kutztown. Ridgeway, he's going to go up. And he is out of bounds. Still Kutztown ball. There'll be no foul called there, but it will be an out-of-bounds play there. So a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. And it is a 45-37 game in favor of the Hawks of Indiana University. And they have played so well tonight. No doubt about it. The way they've shot the ball, 61.5% compared to a 45.5% for Kutztown. They're also shooting the free throws better. 85.7% compared to 54.5%. Kutztown has yet to lead in this game. For a team that played Indiana so close earlier on in the season, an 8-point game is a lot better than what it was earlier on. 13-point lead was the largest lead of the game for IUP. And now, as we end of the first half with 44 seconds to play, Kutztown draws a little closer here as they trail by 8. Johnson to Ridgeway. Ridgeway for 3. That shot is no good into the hands of Cottrell. The 30-second timeout. So a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here once again. 28.8 seconds to play in the first half. an 8-point lead for IUP. And Kutztown, you know, this is not the game that they wanted to play earlier on. Like I said, before the game, they wanted to start getting going early and limit this IUP team from taking shots that, you know, will just go in. But they've, you know, it's been all IUP in this one. You're looking at the turnovers and 9 turnovers for IUP and 6 for Kutztown only means that, you know, IUP has turned the ball over, and we saw so many times that the team with the most turnovers more often than not loses the game, and Kutztown just unable to capitalize on the turnovers. Oh, boy. The pass went over the head of Lombardi and out of bounds. And the pass there from Glover out of bounds, the Kutztown ball. Josh Johnson checks into the game for Kutztown. And now Ridgeway. Shot clock dead. 23 seconds left. And now Kutztown with a chance to make it a 6 or 5 point game. Going into the second half, going to the locker room and make those adjustments. Ridgeway slows down the pace, playing the point guard position the way that he plays. Dish over to Connolly. That's good for 2. Clock still running. 3 seconds left. 2 seconds left. 1 last shot from Glover. That's no good. And that will do it for the first half. So just like that, a 6-point game after the assist from Ridgeway to Connolly makes it a 45-39 game going into the locker room, going into the second half. So Kutztown trailing by only 6 points, and that's a lot better than what it was earlier on in this game. Looking at some stats here for Kutztown, they have had all their players come into the game, and all of their players have found ways to score. And game in and game out, we see that the offense that Coach Bernie Driscoll and his coaching staff puts on the floor game in and game out, and they do a great job of distributing the ball the right ways over and over again. Max Wagner leading the Kutztown Golden Bears in points with 10, coming off the bench in 12 minutes of play. We saw an increased minutes load for Wagner with the early 2 fouls for Dan Cuevas and Josh Johnson. The problem is there, Max Wagner, he has 2 fouls for his credit as well. So definitely not something that they wanted to see in this game, putting them into a predicament where you could potentially get 3 of your key big men into foul trouble earlier on. The good news is that 2 fouls is not 3 or 4. So definitely going to be something to look at there. Josh Johnson, 6 points, 3 rebounds, the 2 turnovers in 11 minutes on the floor. Ryan Connolly, he has 2 points and 5 rebounds, and he's 0 for 1 from 3. Looking at Dan Cuevas, 4 points, 1 rebound, and then the 2 fouls. Ethan Ridgeway has 2 assists, 4 points, a rebound. Anthony Lee, 3 points, 6 points, 3 rebounds, 1 assist. And looking at Wagner, 10 points, 3 rebounds, is definitely, and 3 steals to his credit as well, has been the key to this game so far. Max Wagner, the freshman, showcasing his abilities for this Kutztown team. Really a bright spot for the future of this one. For IUP, Devin Cottrell, 10 points, who had that game winner back in December against Kutztown to win that ball game. 10 points, 2 rebounds, and a block. Jacobo Diaz, 7 rebounds, 2 points, 3 turnovers, and a steal. Anthony Glover, 9 points and an assist. Aaron Hutton, one assist. And Dante Lombardo, 5 assists and 12 points for the IUP Crimson Hawks. Daniel Eck has 9 points and 4 rebounds for IUP. First half field goal percentage, IUP shooting 61.5% from the field. Kutztown shooting 45.7% from the field. And they've been the Golden Bears are 1 of 6 from 3. IUP 7 of 13 from 3 as well. 6 of 7 from the line is IUP. 6 of 11 from the line is Kutztown. So Kutztown, they have not led in this game at all, this entire game. And IUP has led by as much as 13 points. So IUP leads it at the half here at the Joe Retton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University. A score of 45-39. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back for the second half of this game between Kutztown and IUP as NCAA tournament first round action here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
You're listening to The Halftime Show. Stay tuned for more Kutztown basketball action. from Blink 182 to 21 Pilots. Check out 90s and Now Alternative with Emily Gavin every Friday morning at 10 to 12 EST. Stream it live at www.kutztown.edu/KUR. And catch up after the show at KUR Alternative over on the Twitter account. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University. Listening to the Halftime Show. Stay tuned for more Kutztown basketball action.
Yeah.
You are listening to The Halftime Show. And now, back to the game for more Kutztown basketball action.
Back here at Joe Wright Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University. Getting ready for the second half of Kutztown basketball here in the NCAA tournament. First round is a 45-39 game for IUP. And it was a lot worse than that just a couple of minutes ago. It was a 13-point game at one point in this game. And IUP playing so well, shooting 61.5% from the field. And they have gotten distribution from so many different players. Kutztown has as well, but they have definitely not shot the ball as well as IUP has. Diaz, 2 points. He was the PSAC Player of the Year, but he does of the West, but he does have 7 rebounds. Devin Cottrell, 10 points. Dante Lombardi has 12 points for the Crimson Hawks. Kutztown, led by Max Wagner, the freshman who has seen a considerable amount of minutes due to foul trouble for Josh Johnson and Dan Cuevas in the first half of this one. Max Wagner, 10 points, 3 rebounds, 2 of them offensive, 4 or 5 from the line, and has 3 steals. So defensive game for Wagner in this one as we are ready to get the second half of basketball action away here. 20 minutes on the clock, 20 minutes to go here at Joe Retton Arena. Anthony Lee to Connolly. Kutztown with possession early. Cuevas back to Lee, over to Ridgeway, top of the key. Back to Johnson, back over to Ridgeway, to Lee, 10 seconds on the shot clock. Lee for 3. That's no good. Rebound picked up by Cuevas, up with it, no good, but it's fouled on the play. So Kutztown taking the momentum that they encompassed back at the beginning, at the end of the first half, and Cuevas will go to the line to shoot 2 shots. Cuevas at the line. Get his first free throws of the day. The first one is good. So it's 45-40, a 5-point game. And Kutztown has clawed back into this game little by little. That was the key to the game as Cuevas misses the second free throw off the front of the rim. Didn't even hit the top of the rim. They high pass to Lombardi. And now IUP. Hutton to Lombardi. Underneath. Guarded hard. And now top of the key. Back to Lombardi. 6 seconds to shoot. Diaz guarded by Cuevas. Diaz looks for it. 1 second to shoot. That shot's no good. And Johnson tried to come away with the ball. And it'll be an out-of-bounds on Kutztown. It'll be IUP ball from the quarter. Lombardi passes it in, a fresh shot clock. And now Lombardi again, top of the key, guarded by Josh Johnson. Screen set, looks for the open man underneath the Cottrell. That shot's no good, rebound by Cuevas. And now Ridgeway controls the ball for Kutztown. Ridgeway dribbles around, top of the key. And now to the right side over to Lee. Lee back to Ridgeway to Johnson. Johnson has it, dribbles around underneath against Cottrell and up in good. Josh Johnson gets 2 to fall and brings the Golden Bears to 3 points now to IUP. A 3-point game with 18:25 to play. Glover spins around. Back over to Lombardi. Lombardi drives, and good, off the glass. And it's 47-42. Johnson inbounds it to Ridgeway. Kutztown trails by 5. Ridgeway to Cuevas. Cuevas sizes it up. That's good. Dan Cuevas gets 2 to fall. And it's 47-44 with 17:48 to play. A 3-point game for the Crimson Hawks. Lombardi. And back to Hutton. Hutton to Lombardi. Lombardi drives, double teamed by Johnson and Connolly. Left side for three. That's good. Aaron Hutton puts it in for the IUP Crimson Hawks, and it's a 50-44 game with 17:20 to play. Ridgeway to Anthony Lee. Lee drives, guarded by Diaz. Back to Dan Cuevas. Dribbles around, up, blocked, and out of bounds. No good, but it will stay with Kutztown. Off the hand of Cottrell. And Blake Danilak. Blake Danilak checks in for IUP. Ridgeway shot. That's no good. Off. Johnson went up for it. That's no good. Off the hand and out of bounds on Johnson. IUP will take over the ball. Cobo Diaz checks into the game for IUP. Lombardi. For three, Diaz. That shot's no good. Rebound by Ridgeway. Ridgeway on the run. Ridgeway up and no good. Try to get the tip in from Johnson. Back in the hands of Ridgeway. Ridgeway puts it up for two. That's no good. Tries again. And nothing goes in for Kutztown. Absolutely nothing. And a foul on the play as Glover went with the ball and got caught up with Ethan Ridgeway. And the foul is called against Ridgeway. That's Ridgeway's first foul of the game. 6-point lead for IUP. After one miss after another from Kutztown, nothing went in. And now IUP has a chance to capitalize. Cobo Diaz. Back over for three. That shot's no good from Lombardi, but they get a fresh shot clock and the offensive rebound in the hands of Anthony Glover. Glover to Lombardi. Top of the key, guarded by Connolly. Back over to Glover. He's going to go, and a blocking foul is called and one. Drives to the basket. Gets the 2 points and the blocking foul called against Cuevas. That's his third foul. Timeout on the floor. 15:57 to play in regulation. IUP 52, Kutztown 44. You're listening to NCAA Division II Tournament Basketball here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Listen every Friday night from 11 to midnight Eastern Time for Kim Scott and the Block Party Radio. You will hear the best in urban, smooth, Latin jazz, and the jazz standards that you love. Hear it here on www.kutztown.edu/KUR. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University.
Back here at the Joe Retton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University in Fairmont, West Virginia, is Kutztown trailing by 8 points to the Indiana University of Pennsylvania Crimson Hawks, 52-44 with 15:57 to play in regulation. It's been a tough game for Kutztown. Offensively and defensively as well. It's just, you know, IUP has been the better team all game long, and really there's not much else that you could expect as IUP has been unbelievable all season long. Kutztown, though, also unbelievable. So both teams had their 18-game win streak snapped last weekend at the hands of Shippensburg. Of all teams, Shippensburg was the team, and now they paid off. They got the 2 seed in the tournament in the region, and they advanced to the second round. So one team from the PSAC will play on tomorrow, and now as we try to figure out who will be the second team from the PSAC seeing another game tomorrow against Fairmont State. Ridgeway now up, no good. Wagner went up for it, and the rebound by the Crimson Hawks. Lombardi now brings it up. A 9-point lead for IUP. And a foul called on the play. Against Ryan Connolly, his second foul of the game. The shot, that's good. That's a 3-point play by Lombardi. And he gets the three. And then Kutztown inbounds it and loses the ball out of bounds. Unbelievable. Timeout called by Coach Purdy Driscoll. Is a full timeout. We're going to take a quick break. 56-44 the score with 15:32 to play in regulation. We'll be right back after this. You're listening to NCAA Division II basketball action here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Listen to Plum Stereo with DJ Plum every Saturday afternoon from 3 to 5 Eastern Time. Join her whimsical adventures into the bizarre musical worlds for the lighthearted and the carefree. Hear it here at www.kutztown.edu/KUR. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University.
Back here at Joe Retton Arena, it's a 56-44 ball game for IUP. With 15:32 to play in regulation, a lot of basketball to be played. A 12-point deficit for the Golden Bears. Josh Liddick here on the call on the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR. Kutztown made the long trek all the way here to Fairmont, West Virginia yesterday. A six-hour van ride and what we went through, all kinds of snow and sleet and all you can imagine to get to where we're at right here. And we have a good ball game here. 12-point game. Danilak to Diaz underneath. Top of the key to Lombardi. Passes it away, and a foul called on the play as he went for the ball, but it will be a foul against Anthony Lee. So Anthony Lee, he gets his first foul of the game. First one is no good from Danilak. Second one coming for Danilak. A career 66.7% free throw shooter. He's shooting 70.4% from the field, from the line this season. Connolly almost lost it. To the corner, that's good for three. So it's Anthony Lee for three, and brings the deficit to 10 points with 15:03 to play in regulation. Lombardi to the Kobo Diaz, guarded by Josh Johnson. A good matchup between Diaz and Johnson. The reigning PSAC West Player of the Year, and last year's PSAC East Player of the Year. 2 seconds to shoot. Danilak misses it. That's no good. And in the hands of Ridgeway. 4-on-4. Ridgeway up with it. And one. So a foul called on the play. Ridgeway went up for the layup, and it's good. And a layup. Gets the end, one hooker to line to shoot. Try to get three. Try to bring this deficit to 7 points. Kutztown has not led once in this game. Ridgeway to the line. And he misses it. Kutztown is struggling from shooting their free throws in this game. Sizes up the two. That is spot on. Nothing else you can say about that for Brandon Spain. So Brandon Spain gets the two, the jumper, and it's a 10-point game. A foul called on the play. And that's called against Aaron Hutton. That's Hutton's second foul of the game. Connolly, inbound play to Ridgeway. Ridgeway over to Connolly, double teamed, puts it up, tries to get the backboard. Johnson gets the offensive rebound and good. So Josh Johnson, 2 points and good, and it's a 59-51 game. Kutztown trying to prove that they can still find a way to come back and take a lead here. They trail by 8 points with 13:40 to play. The three from the corner, that is unbelievably good. Another three for IUP. And they just have been draining them from three in this one. 10 3-pointers for IUP. Max Wagner puts two up and good for Kutztown. It's an 11-point game, 62-53 with 13:10 to play in regulation. Lombardi. So it'll be a foul called against Max Wagner, his third. And the Kutztown just needs to not let their emotions get to them late into the game. And just know that there's 13 minutes to go, and anything can happen in those 13 minutes. It's March. It's March Madness. That shot's no good. Rebound by Connolly. And now Kutztown on the run. Tries to get the tempo up a little bit. Ridgeway drives. He has foul on the play. And the foul called there against Brandon Spain. So the second foul called against Spain. And now Ridgeway will go to the line. Trailing by 9 points. Ridgeway, 0 for 2 from the line, and now 0 for 3. He is struggling completely. Ridgeway shooting 3 of 15 from the field. 20%. And 2 assists. The all-time leader in assists in KU history as a junior. Set the single season record, set the single game record, set the career record this season. And only 2 to show here in this Atlantic Regional. First round. Ridgeway got one there. It's an 8-point game. Cobo Diaz. Garden. And a foul. Going to be called against Max Wagner, his fourth. So that will put Wagner in foul trouble. And it'll be Martin Dietrich to check in the game for Wagner. So Wagner will have a seat. Golden Bears leading scorer in this one with 12 points. Lombardi, a wide open Diaz for 2 and good. And it's a 10-point game for IUP as they just keep on keeping on here at Joe Wrighton Arena. Anthony Lee rides the baseline. That's no good, not kind. And the rebound by IUP. And now the Crimson Hawks will look to extend their lead. Lombardi. The drive. Top the key, wide open for 3. That's no good. And Diaz gets the putback and good. 56-54 with 11:40 to play. Ridgeway to Connolly. Connolly the deep 3. That's good. Gets a little life back into it. And the 3 ball is good by Ryan Connolly. And a 9-point game. 66-57 with 11:25 to play. Lombardi. double teamed. And gets it back over out of bounds to Glover. Little block there by Lee. And now underneath to Cottrell. 10 seconds to shoot. Cottrell puts it up. That's good. Uses his height to an advantage over Josh Johnson. And it's 68-57, an 11-point game. Ridgeway, he's going to drive to the basket, and that's good. Ethan Ridgeway, a size advantage there a little bit. Really, no, it's pretty much a push between him and Glover. They're pretty much the same size. Lombardi loses it. Kutztown ball. And now Kutztown, trailing by 11 points, will get the ball back. Timeout is called. 10:40 to play in regulation. IUP 68, Kutztown 59. You're listening to NCAA Division II Tournament Basketball here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
You're listening to the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR. Did you miss a show? Want to hear your favorite shows on your time? Check out our Mixcloud page where you can hear select programming on your schedule. Mixcloud is a digital audio streaming platform service rethinking radio. Just go to mixcloud.com/KU radio and click on the show that you want to hear. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University.
Back here at Joe Retton Arena, it's a 68-59 game. IUP with the lead here. And Kutztown has been struggling all game long to find a rhythm and find themselves to take, you know, get close in on a lead for an advantage that, you know, IAP, they've led by as much as 13 points, and Kutztown has not even, the game has only been tied for 31 seconds, and that was at the beginning of the game when it was 0-0. Kutztown, not one lead in this game, but they're still managing to hang with this tough Crimson Hawk team. It's only a 9-point game, and still a lot of time to be played here. Oh, a little under 11 minutes to play, 10:40 to be exact. And now Kutztown with the basket, and then now a chance after the timeout to get another chance here. Ridgeway puts it up for two. That's good. A good floater play by Ethan Ridgeway, up and good for two, and it's a 7-point game. And now Kutztown will just try to get back on defense, play good defense against this IUP team, and figure out a way to crack the code. Underneath, that's no good. A steal, Connolly to Ridgeway. Kutztown gets the momentum they need. Little dribble drive underneath, and foul on the play, a blocking foul called. So it'll be a foul call against Lombardi, his third of the game, team fifth. So Ridgeway will go to the line. And Ridgeway is struggling from the line. Another miss for Ridgeway. And you look at the free throws attempted. Nine. If you want to make all nine of those, Kutztown will be in the driver's seat with the lead. And he misses the second free throw. So Ridgeway, one of six from the line. Under 10 minutes to play is a 7-point lead for IUP. Lombardi to Diaz, guarded by Cuevas. Underneath. A little spin move, and he thought he lost the ball. It'll be out of bounds, but it will still be IUP ball. Aaron Hutton checks into the game for the Crimson Hawks. Top of key to Diaz, guarded by Dietrich. Diaz spins around, draws it up. That's no good in the hands of Danielek, and now Lee on the run for Kutztown. Fouled. And that foul will be called against Hutton. Will be against Diaz's third. So Kobo Diaz gets his third foul of the game. And Devin Cottrell checks into the game for the Crimson Hawks and for Daniel Lack. Cuevas to Ridgeway. Ridgeway puts it up, back in his hands. No good. Anthony Lee for three. That's no good. Gets another rebound. Top of the key to Lee, over to Ridgeway. A fresh shot clock. Ridgeway puts it up, nothing doing. Cuevas with the putback in, good. So Dan Cuevas puts two on the board, and it's back to a five-point game. We have a little bit of a momentum push cooking here at Joe Retton Arena. Get those turnovers. Double teamed a little bit. Dietrich. And a foul called on the play. So a foul called on the play. And that will send Lombardi to the line. And Josh Johnson over to the scorer's table. The free throw is good from Lombardi. So he'll go to the line to shoot another one after the 1-1. Braden Spain into the lineup for IUP. Daniel Lack in. Kobo Diaz and Glover both out. And Lombardi makes the second. It's back to a seven-point game with 8:41 to play. Ridgeway. Shoots it. That shot is no good. Another miss for Ridgeway. And now IUP back on the run. And good. Devin Cottrell puts two up for IUP. And that is 72-63 lead for the Crimson Hawks. Ridgeway to Johnson. Johnson spin move and no good. But he'll go to the line to shoot two. So it'll be a foul called against Devin Cottrell. That's his third foul of the game. So Johnson will head to the line to shoot two shots here. Johnson's first one is good. Settles it down, puts it up for one. Now we'll try to get the second one. Johnson has 11 points in this game. He's 5 of 7 from the field, 5 rebounds, 11 points. Okay, number 2. Went around the rim, up, took the lucky bounce and in. And it's 72-65. Ridgeway will check out of the game. Anthony Lee in, Howard Sellers in, Weidelman, Johnson, and Cuevas to start the 5 in for Kutztown. The pass went awry, but now IUP on the run. Lombardi to set it up for the Crimson Hawks. Under 8 to play in regulation. Is a 72-65 IUP lead. Lombardi guarded by Beidelman. 1-1. The fadeaway jumper is no good. And now Sellers on the run. The ball trickled away. Went up for it. Got all ball. Beidelman gets the rebound and in. And now it's back to another five-point game. Kutztown will try to get back on defense, force a turnover, and get another chance to draw closer to this IUP team. Cottrell, back to Spain. Spain guarded by Cuevas. Back to Lombardi. Lombardi drives, and he finds Danielak. Danielak takes the three. That's good. Blake Danielak puts the three up, and just like clockwork, another three for IUP. And just when Kutztown thought that they could crack the code and draw a little closer away from the five-point deficit, is back to 8 points. Out of bounds. And there'll be a foul called against Blake Danielak. That's his fourth foul of the game. Timeout on the floor. 6:56 to play in regulation. It's IUP 75, Kutztown 67. You're listening to NCAA Division II tournament basketball action here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Like KUR, an award-winning radio station, on Facebook to receive exciting daily content delivered straight to your newsfeed. You'll discover diverse music, breaking news, and engaging student DJ content. Visit facebook.com/KUR1670 to join the fun. Remember to use hashtag KURadio on social media. We are the radio voice of Kutztown University, KUR.
Back here at Joe Retton Arena, an 8-point game for the IUP Crimson Hawks, as it has been all IUP all night long. Kutztown has yet to lead in this game whatsoever. Kutztown struggling shooting the ball in this game, 45.7% from the field, compared to IUP shooting 61.5% from the field. Ethan Ridgeway has put up 20 shots, and only five of them have went in, and struggled. And he's been the spark plug for this team all season long. And having him shooting poorly has not been helpful for Kutztown. With Dan Cuevas to the line to shoot. An 8-point game. Cuevas, the first one is good. So he makes the first of the 1-1, and now he will have a chance to get the second one and try to bring it back to a 6-point lead deficit as he nails the second. And a timeout is called on the floor. 75-69 the score. A 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. And Kutztown, you know, it's only a 6-point game, but it just doesn't feel like a 6-point game because every time that they try to cut the deficit, IUP drills a three to go even further ahead. So it's been, especially here, you have a crowd where on the side that Kutztown would normally be sitting on, they would not, there's hardly any Kutztown people that made it on this trip. Most of you are at home or in a bar or something listening to the game here and trying to see that your Kutztown Golden Bears take a victory here. A lot of IUP folks in the house as well. Kobo Diaz, top of the key, and back over to Spain. And he's at the top of the key dancing around with 10 seconds to shoot on the shot clock, 6:33 to play. Spain, he's going to drive, dishes it out to Kobo Diaz, and he nails the 3-point field goal. Kobo Diaz from the right wing, that's good, and it's 78-69. Johnson went up for it, fouled on the play. Well, the question here is, will Kutztown make one of their storied comebacks that we've seen all season long? They've done an unbelievable job of coming back in close games or games where they thought that they would be so far away and miraculously tried to come away with victories in key situations. And tonight, Anthony Lee puts one up there. It's an 8-point game. It seems like it's close. It seems like it's far, but at the same time, anything can happen. With 6:19 to play, Kutztown trying to keep their season alive. And the second free throw is good. So a 7-point game. Playing a little press defense, trying to force a turnover and have a chance to draw a little closer. Lombardi guarded by Ridgeway. Jacobo Diaz. Diaz to Lombardi. Lombardi for three. Oh my goodness. Another three-pointer for Lombardi. That is his four three-pointer of the game. And Johnson's shot is no good. So a 10-point game. Lombardi slows it down, and it's 5:40 to play in the second half. Trying to advance to face Fairmont State tomorrow in the second round of the NCAA Division II tournament. A tough Fairmont State team, number one in the region, hosting here. 5 seconds to shoot. Lombardi loses it, and now Ridgeway picks it up. And it'll be a reach-in foul called against Lombardi. So that's Lombardi's fourth foul of the game. A questionable foul there for Lombardi with 5:15 to play. One of the key players of this team. 20 points for Lombardi. And four fouls, and Ridgeway continues to struggle shooting free throws. Another free throw miss for Ridgeway. He's 1 of 7 from the line. And the second one is good, so he gets 1 of 2. He gets his 12th point of the game. Stolen away. Ridgeway comes up with it underneath to Johnson. Johnson misses the layup. And no good. And Kobo Diaz with the rebound. A prime possession there to try to get the ball in, and nothing doing for Josh Johnson. Diaz to Lombardi, guarded by Wagner. Lombardi back over to the corner. That's no good. Gets his own rebound. That's no good. Anthony Lee comes up with it. Kutztown on the run. To Wagner. Wagner puts it up and good. Max Wagner. Another 2 points for the freshman. And it's 81-74, a 7-point game. Cottrell puts two up. And IUP extends their lead. It's 83-74. And Anthony Lee puts two up and good. 83-76, a 7-point game once again. Kutztown needs to play that defense to force turnover here. And oh, what a steal by Ridgeway. Lee to Johnson, up and fouled on the play. And what an incredible sequence of events. And that will be Kobo Diaz's fourth foul of the game. So two of IUP's key players, one foul away from finding themselves on the bench for the rest of the game. It's a 7-point lead for IUP, and now Josh Johnson to the line. And the first one is no good. Another missed free throw for Kutztown. 4:04 to play is a 7-point lead. And now Johnson to try to get the second one to go in. KU. And he misses it. Another free throw miss for Josh Johnson. He is 2 of 5 from the line. 2 of 6 to be precise. Lombardi guarded by Ridgeway. 7-point game. Top of the key to Diaz for three. That is good. Another three for IUP. That's their 14th three-pointer of the game. That's no good. Foul by Josh Johnson. So now a 10-point game again. Another foul against Josh Johnson. His third foul of the game. timeout on the floor. With 3:31 to play in the game, Kutztown trails IUP 86-76. You're listening to NCAA Division II Tournament Basketball here on the Golden Bear Radio Network.
Like it loud? Check out Bad Hair Day with Sarah P. every Tuesday afternoon from 1 to 3 Eastern Time. Rock out to the greatest punk, rock, alternative, and everything in between. Stream it live at www.kutztown.edu/KUR. KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University.
Back here at Joe Retton Arena on the campus of Fairmont State University in Fairmont, West Virginia. Very cold, Fairmont, West Virginia. It was like 20 degrees earlier on today in the morning. 3:31 to play in the game as Kutztown trailed the entirety of this game. 86-76 to score. Kutztown trying to stay alive and book a ticket to the second round tomorrow. But it's a tall order. IUP has shot the ball so very well all game long. From three, from the field, as Lombardi to the line gets the first of a 1-1 and puts the Crimson Hawks up by 11 points. The second one from Lombardi is also good. Ryan Connolly checks into the game for the Golden Bears. In the inbound play, Wagner to Ridgeway. Let's the ball roll out. Waits for the clock there. Connolly for three. That's no good. And the rebound there. And it'll be a foul against Devin Cottrell. It'll be a foul against Cottrell. That will send the Golden Bears to the line to shoot two. It'll be Max Wagner at the line. Cottrell now has four fouls. So four fouls for Cottrell. Four fouls for Diaz. Four fouls for Lombardi. And now Wagner to the line. And he misses the second one. Dreadful night from the line for this Kutztown team. They've attempted 30 free throws, and have only made 15 of them. It'd be a whole different ball game if they would have made all the free throws that they've taken and get those free shots. It's a 12-point lead for the IUP Crimson Hawks with 3:11 to play. Little time remaining for Kutztown to make a push back here underneath. And that fadeaway shot is good. Lombardi. 91-76. With under three to play. Ridgeway. Beidleman back to Ridgeway. Ridgeway up. And he's fouled on the play. That'll be the third foul against Britain and Spain. And now Ridgeway to the line. He shoots two and missed the first one, almost an air ball. Completely. Ridgeway, 2 of 9 from the line. So Ridgeway will try to go for the second one and try to draw closer. A 14-point lead for IUP with 2:43 to play as Kutztown, a little over 2 minutes away from watching their season come to an end after an incredible season. Went to the Sweet 16 last year, lost to West Liberty. This team, on all accounts, much improved than last year's team. And this time, they met a date with IUP, and they've just been too much to handle. Over. 2:27 to play. Back to Glover. To Diaz. Back to Lombardi. Top of the key. Guarded by Ridgeway. Out of bounds. It'll stay with IUP. With 6 seconds on the shot clock. 13-point lead for IUP. Up and good. Danielak puts it up for the Hawks. And it's 92-77 with 2:13 to play. Anthony Lee for three. That's no good. And rebound by Diaz. Glover. Double team Ridgeway and Beitelman. Right side back over to Lombardi. The pass to the left wing. Diaz, and he walks on the play. IUP's up at 15 points, and they're complaining about a travel. They're going to play in the second round tomorrow. At this point, Connolly, top of the key for three. That's no good. Rebound by Diaz, and that'll do it. IUP will just look to finish this one out as Kutztown will watch their season come to an end. Dribbling right in front of me here. Around, tries to force a turnover, nothing doing, off the leg, off the foot, and a foul called on the play. The foul called against Blake Danielak. That's his fifth foul. Danielak's gone. Out of the game. Ridgeway will see his night come to an end as he will head to the bench. Ridgeway, 5 of 20 from the field, 13 points. And now Beitelman. Beitelman for three, draws it up and good. Gets the three to go. And Beitelman will get the three. And it's a 92-80 game with 106 to play. 12-point lead for IUP. The 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. And for those of you that are tuning in here on KUR, Kutztown trailing by 12. No leads the whole game. IUP has completely taken over and shot the ball really well, around 58% from the field. Kutztown shooting 43.5% from the field. They have found ways to get closer. They have found ways to come within 5 points, 7 points, but once they get to that point, IUP found ways to stop them continually. And it's a 12-point game here as IUP will look to run the clock out and head to the second round to face Fairmont State tomorrow, under a minute to play. A foul called on the play. That's going to be against Demetrius Bennett, who's finding his first minutes of the game for Kutztown. Hey, And now all the seniors on the court for Kutztown. These guys have been through a lot in 4 years. I've watched Johnson and Beidelman and since my freshman year. This is my 66th game called. And my final one as a student at Kutztown. And he makes the second 14-point game. And now Beidelman will bring it up. Try to make one last good play. Bennett's deep three is no good. To Sellers. Sellers puts it up off the backboard and no good. And now IUP will come away with the victory. Kutztown season comes to a close. And for these seniors that are on the floor, this will be the last time they see the court for a lot of them. We'll just dribble it out. 1 second on the shot clock. We'll take the shot clock violation. And Kutztown will take the ball. 11.7 seconds to play. And it's a 94-80 game as Kutztown. Beidelman, 5 seconds, will hold the ball as the captain. Fitting end to the game, and the season comes to a close. Kutztown falls 94-80, the Indiana University of Pennsylvania Crimson Hawks. Kutztown season comes to a close, and my broadcasting career at Kutztown as a student comes to a close as well. 94-80 final score. Kutztown will fall to 26-4 on the season. That's where they'll end, as they end on a two-game losing streak. Final stats, looking at it here. Ethan Ridgeway, 13 points. Tied for second on the team on the game. Anthony Lee also had 13 points. Ridgeway, though, shot 5 of 20 from the field. Max Wagner, 14 points, 4 rebounds, and 3 steals for the Golden Bears. IUP, their season continues, 28-3, as they will head to the second round and face the Fairmont State Falcons tomorrow. That will do it for Kutztown season. That will do it for the season for us as well. Final score, 94-80, IUP, as Kutztown season. What an incredible season for Kutztown. Looking at where they came from, they were on an 18-game winning streak. They found themselves winning in close fashions. A PSAC East Division Championship win for the second year in a row. They played their hearts out all season long. Ethan Ridgeway, his season will continue, or his career will continue next year. Josh Johnson, Ryan Connolly, Austin Beidelman, Howard Sellers, Martin Dietrich, they will be missed next season. So for the end of the year, final score, IUP 94, Kutztown 80. Thank you for tuning in here on KUR. For BD Blake at the KUR studios and the KUR crew, as it's been an incredible season calling Golden Bear basketball. It's been a pleasure. Signing off for the final time this season, I'm Josh Liddick. Thank you for listening. You've been listening to NCAA Division II basketball here on the Golden Bear Radio Network. Have a good night, everybody.
Thank you for listening to this presentation of Golden Bear Basketball, only on KUR, the radio voice of Kutztown University. For more information, go to www.kutztown.edu/KUR and the KU Athletics website at KUBears.com. This has been a presentation of the Golden Bear Network, only on KUR. Thank you for listening.